Hello, everybody, and welcome to Mass Effect. I am joined today with my friend Sophia once again, who helped me with a recent Thursday episode. Say hello.
Hello.
And yeah, we're going to be playing a little bit of Mass Effect today. I realized that when we did the video last time, I was recording Neverwinter Nights, and I was just terrible because I had no idea where we were going. So, today we're just going to do something casual. We're going to play a little bit more. We're going to play another game that that Sophia here worked on, and we're just going to have some fun today. Now, did you play much Mass Effect after you finished with it?
Yes, I did. Well, I played a lot while I was working on it, but I actually did play all three of them in a row sometime
later.
Oh,
wow.
Yeah.
That's pretty awesome. Like, I've always found that whenever I played a game that I used to work on, I just could not bring myself to play very far into it, so.
I guess I had waited a while since I did play all three of them in a row, so.
That'd have been like kind of a couple of years or something like that?
Yeah.
Okay, so here's the question everybody wants to know. Male Shepard or Femme Shep?
Femme Shep.
Okay.
Of course.
I don't know. A lot of people. I always find that like Mark Meer seems to get like a lot more hate than he deserves. I thought that he did a pretty good job, but it's true. Like I think it's just kind of hard to deny that Femme Shep seems to kind of have won the Mass Effect war for voice actor.
Oh really? Oh, I always play female if it's available.
I suppose. Yeah, it's just I've always seemed to notice, like, I spend a lot of time on Reddit and so on, so whenever people talk about Shepard, it's like, oh, well, you know, it's always Femme Shep, you know? Like,
right.
I don't know, the delivery of male Shep is just so dry or something like that. I'm like, that's kind of sad and unfortunate, but... Okay, so I'm going to ask you to tell us what kind of a character we should make. We've got Spacer, Colonist, Earthborn. Do you even remember the differences on these ones?
Vaguely.
So,
which is the one that grew up on the streets? Was that the
that would be Earthborn. Yeah, all right. Street kid, soul survivor, war hero, or ruthless? What do you think?
Oh, which was the one? Do you remember they say that his team died on a coup?
Yes, that'll be Soul Survivor.
I always heard that as his team died on a cruise. And I was always thinking, what type of cruise were they on?
Not a pleasure cruise, I guess.
No.
Well, unless it was like bad food poisoning or something like that.
It could have been, yes.
The one thing that, I guess the interesting thing about taking the Soul Survivor is I noticed, like for each of these characters, you get like some side missions that kind of randomly populate in the game. I know that you can end up on... Actually, you might even return to a coup, I'm not sure, but it's like everybody died to like a thresher maw or something like that, right?
Right.
So you go back there and all of a sudden you get like ambushed by thresher maws and it's just terrible. So So what do you think? Shall we let our old group die on a cruise?
Let's do that.
All right. Sounds great. Now, do you have a preferred class that you usually play? I keep trying to play Adept because I like having magical powers, but I always was much better with like an infiltrator.
No, I didn't have a particular preference.
All right, well, let's try Adept. You can always do some really funny things with just the physics of of like singularity and push and so on. So,
sounds good.
Yeah, to save everybody the agony of watching me fiddle with sliders all day, I'll just go ahead and take the default Femme Shep face. But
okay.
There we go. Jane Shepard, ready to roll. Identification confirmed. So let's get rolling.
Okay.
All right. Oh, I gotta say though, like I'm a huge RPG fan, and Mass Effect has to be probably my favorite series, like ever.
I like it too.
Yeah. Oh, so fun. Like, oh, I'll not talk over the opening. Some people really hate that. Learn to look out for herself.
She saw her whole unit die on a cruise.
Very terrible cruise.
Yeah.
Every soldier has scars. Shepard's a survivor.
Is that the kind of person we want protecting the galaxy?
Oh, Udina, you little shithead. Anybody who's played through the series knows what I'm talking about, right?
I think so.
They always let you punch the reporter.
The reporter, yeah.
I wish that you could have socked Udina in the chin a lot more than you ever got the opportunity to do so.
Well, he gets his moment, I guess.
He does, but you gotta wait two games to get there, right?
It's worth it.
It is. It's absolutely worth it. But, like, oh, I don't know. That man infuriates me.
This music gets me every time. I love it.
Oh, yeah. No, the composer for Mass Effect. I'm trying to remember. I thought it might have been like Mark Morgan or something like that. But
no, he was playing Scape Torment.
Right. And I think the Fallout games too, actually. I might be wrong. Mm-hmm. I'm terrible, but yeah. Oh, I can't remember exactly who it was that did the themes for Mass Effect, but they were always just fantastic.
Yeah.
And I mean, even when they switched over to Mass Effect 3 to the other guy, his stuff was also really, really good. Of course, he had a lot of good stuff to work off of, so.
Yeah.
And there she is.
She looks a little cranky.
What's that?
She looks a little bit cranky, yeah.
Yeah, you would be too if you had to wear a skin tight jumpsuit all the time. Now, did you do a lot of character like facial customization when you played the game, or were you one of the defaulters?
For me, I tried to make her look like me, but she ended up looking like Bjork for some reason. And I look nothing like Bjork, so I don't know what happened. I think I gave up at that point.
In the right light, I could see it. Internal emissions engaged. All systems online. Yeah, I always, like, I can't tell you how many times, because none of this is skippable, right? Like, I can press any button.
Mm-hmm.
How many times I've gotten to that scene where it turns around and you look at the character's face and I'm like, oh god, I did this completely wrong.
Oh. That actually happened to me in Dragon Age, and I got I got quite a way in. And it wasn't until a particular cutscene that I realized that her eyes made her look completely insane and I couldn't play her anymore, so I had to restart.
Yeah, I always end up with this weird thing where, like, my face, my mouth will glitch out and, like, my teeth will be permanently sticking out of my face or something like that.
<That's gross.
laughs> So, like, buck-toothed Captain Shepard.
That's not good.
Commander. You always expect the worst. But, you know, I guess that's one of the safe things about going with the defaults, eh?
What are we doing? Yeah. Joker, status report. Just cleared the mass relay, Captain. So for the longest time, this Joker was placeholder, voiceover. Oh. And it was perfectly fine. But then when Seth Green did it, it was...
Yeah.
It's just, oh gosh, it was much better.
Oh, I can only imagine. Now, did you guys know that you were going to get Seth Green from the start?
No, I did not know, no.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and he actually ad-libbed some of it. Some of it was different from what the original text was.
Oh, I can only imagine. He seems like the type.
Yeah.
Now, do you watch, like, Robot Chicken or any of the other stuff that he's done, sort of?
I have. I haven't for ages, but I have watched it some. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, one of my favorite TV series. I mean, it's demented and terrible in many ways, but... Hello, racist Presley. How's it going?
That was, Congratulations, Commander. Looks like we had a smooth run. You heading down... That's Murdoch, isn't it?
Is it?
Presley?
Oh, I don't know.
What's his name? Dwight Schultz? Is it?
Is it?
No, we're not sure.
Yeah, I don't remember, but, I mean, it could be. I found that there were a lot of, like, surprising casts in this, like, when you look at the, unlike the IMDb and stuff like that for for Mass Effect.
Yeah. Why send a specter, a Turian specter,
on a shakedown run? It doesn't add up. All right. That's fine. See if I can get some answers when I see him.
Good luck, Commander. No, I'm doubting what I said now.
There's a better chance that you remember it than me. Oh, Corporal Jenkins.
Poor Jenkins.
We better talk to Jenkins at least once before.
Yeah. Before he puts his red shirt on. Yeah.
Yep. Yeah, he should have been the one with the red stripe, eh?
Yeah. Your real action usually ends with me patching up crew members in the infirmary. You need to calm down, Corporal. A good soldier stays cool even under fire. Sorry, Commander, but this waiting's killing me.
I've never been on a mission like this before, not one with a Spectre on board.
Do your job, follow my orders, and there won't be any problems.
Well, that came out a little bit more stern than I expected it would.
This is my big chance. I need to show the brass what I can do.
You're young, Corporal. You have a long career ahead of you.
Oh, if only I knew.
Exactly.
I'm not going to screw this up.
Tell me about Eden Prime.
You're from Eden Prime, aren't you, Jenkins? What's it like?
It's very peaceful, Commander. They've been real careful with development, so you don't have any city noise or pollution. My parents lived on the outskirts of the colony. At night, I used to climb this big hill and stare across the fields back at the lights from the main settlement. It was gorgeous. But when I got older, I realized it was a little too calm and quiet for me. That's why I joined the Alliance. Even Paradise gets boring after a while.
Any idea why Eden Prime was chosen as our destination?
Not really sure, Commander.
Do you think Dr. Chakwas is getting bored? She looks a bit...
Yeah, she looks a little antsy, doesn't she? She's, like, kind of stepping from foot to foot. And, like, she's making some, like, gestures like she wants to say something, but she's not doing it.
The captain's waiting for me. Goodbye, Commander.
There you go.
Oh, I got some Paragon points.
The chatting.
And did you play the game as a Paragon or a Renegade?
Paragon.
Oh, I was always Paragon too. I wanted to do Renegade playthroughs, and I've tried a few times. It really is. Like, I don't know why I have empathy for, like, a PC, like a character in a video game.
I know, but it is difficult. You just, some things you just couldn't bring yourself to do.
What about?
Yeah.
I'm interested in this world we're going to. Eden Prime. I've heard it's quite beautiful.
I've never been there.
But you know of it. It's become something of a symbol for your people, hasn't it? Proof that humanity can not only establish colonies across the galaxy, but also protect them. But how safe is it, really?
If you've got something to say, just say it.
Your people are still newcomers, Shepard. The galaxy can be a very dangerous place. Is the Alliance truly ready for this?
I think it's about time we told the Commander what's really going on.
This mission is far more than a simple shakedown run.
I already figured that out.
We're making a covert pickup on Eden Prime. That's why we needed the stealth systems operational.
What's the payload, Captain?
A research team on Eden Prime unearthed some kind of beacon during an excavation. It was Prothean.
What else can you tell me?
This is Big Shepard. The last time humanity
made I'm tempted to, like, go through and exhaust every conversation option and stuff like that. Like, I always do when I'm playing casually, but it's, you know, in the interest of time.
Yes.
I get some shooting in today, right?
Yeah.
Discovery could affect every species in Council space.
Are we expecting trouble?
I'm always expecting trouble.
I knew he'd say that.
There's more. Oh. Nihilus isn't what a badass, Nihilus. He's also here to reevaluate you. I'm surprised that they didn't do more with the Turians in the course of Mass Effects 1 through 3. Like, I mean, you get to do some stuff with them, but for the most powerful army in the galaxy, basically, like, you don't really see a whole lot of them aside from Garrus, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And I can't even remember if I've ever even seen, like, a female Turian in the course of the game, unless they all look and sound the same.
I can't remember seeing one either.
Yeah. I mean, I'm pretty sure you only even see one Quarian during the entire of the first game, but...
Just tell me what I have to do.
I need to see your skills for myself.
I think they look pretty similar, don't they?
Yeah, well, I mean, I don't know. Is that speciesist? They look all the same?
Could be.
It's the bone faces.
Captain, we got a problem.
Uh-oh.
What's wrong, Joker?
Transmission from Eden Prime, sir. You better see this.
Bring it up on screen.
Hope it's not a giant claw thing.
Yeah, it always looks like a gigantic, like glove, doesn't it?
Yes. I did not like Ashley.
No, I didn't either. Like, I don't know. I had a problem with just, like, her casual disregard for all of the other alien species and like, Mass Effect.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Like, the first time that I played, like, I saved Ashley, but I think in all subsequent playthroughs, I saved Caden.
Caden, yeah.
Yeah. Which, I mean, I don't know. Again, you kind of have to make that one choice or the other, and I feel like I missed the opportunity to see what they did with... Just goes dead. There's nothing. Reverse and hold the 38. And I'm trying to not speak over Seth.
Yeah. Oh, teeth.
Oh, yeah. Little fangs. 17 minutes out, Captain. No other Alliance ships in the area.
Take us in, Joker, fast and quiet. This mission just got a lot more complicated.
A small strike team can move quickly without drawing attention. It's our best chance to secure the beacon.
Okay, everybody looks really angry right at the start. Just those scowls.
Yeah. You're going in.
It just looks like a hand, like, just it reaching does. Out to grab the camera. It kind of starts to look more buggy or possibly like
Scorpion?
Squid-esque later on. Oh, Scorpion. Yeah, I guess that's was that like one of the design inspirations?
I don't know.
Yeah, not on the art team, I suppose.
What about survivors, Captain?
Helping survivors is a secondary objective. The beacon's your top priority.
Approaching drop point one.
Nihilus, are you coming with us?
I move faster on my own.
Such a show-off, look at that.
Oh, yeah. And I mean, as far as I can tell, he's not even wearing a parachute, so I'm kind of interested in seeing what happened, like, between there and now. You know? Ready and able, sir. It's like you land, and he's just, like, half embedded in the ground in front of you.
He's playing.
Oh, well, geez. You all right there, Nihilus?
Didn't Captain America just do that in Winter Soldier?
Oh, I'm sure that he did. Nothing okay. says badass like just went and like jumped down onto the ground without a parachute, I guess. Yep. All right. Well, we're out of time for this episode, but thank you very much for joining us, guys. We're going to continue onward next time, and you'll finally get to see me pull a gun and shoot things. But there you go. At least get one down.
One.
All right. Thanks for watching, everybody.